There's one big problem with the image to video workflow in AI video production. You can control the first frame, but the moment your character turns or your product spins, everything falls apart and the look is out of your control. But now with our new reference to video method, you can upload multiple angles of your character or product and the AI understands them all. It conceptually stitches them together in one coherent video. That means you can finally control your subjects in all dimensions. Plus, you can mix and match characters, objects, and backgrounds up to 7 references in a single shot. And the AI figures out how they all belong together. In this video, I'll show you how to maximize the reference to video feature on Dzine for your AI video creation. Let's get started. First, let's go to Dzine AI. You can grab the link in the description below. On Dzine, let's open a new project. Next, go to AI video. You'll see options for image to video and text to video. We'll choose image to video. Now under the reference tab, you can upload reference images, add a text prompt, and easily generate a video that combines all those references. If we're not sure how to start, we can click these hint presets so that we can learn how to properly prompt for this reference to video tool. For example, let's try this little boy with Christmas tree background. You see that the character of the little boy and also the Christmas tree background is uploaded. We can use the add symbol and we will see that it opens a list of the reference images we have uploaded here. And when you hover over it, you can see the little thumbnail. Just select the one you want. Or we can click the icon next to the image number to automatically insert the tag into the text prompt area so that we reference the image. In this case, the example prompt is image 1 is standing in front of image 2 Christmas tree background, holding a small gift box with both hands. Now here's an important best practice. Always add simple description words if the reference is unclear. So we don't want to assume that AI instantly knows what you mean. For example, the boy in image 1 is pretty obvious because there's only one object. But for image 2, which is the Christmas background, the AI might not know if you mean the entire background or just the tree. So it's better to write Christmas tree background around the tag instead of just leaving it as image 2. Just to clarify in case of confusion. These little clarification helps AI understand exactly what you're referring to, and they make your results more accurate and consistent. Now let's try generating. We can also include optional sound effects. So for example, let's say the boy giggles while a Christmas song plays in the background. Let's click generate and see the result. In this result, the little boy is placed in the scene and the background we uploaded is consistent with the image that we have. And the boy is carrying the gift with both hands as instructed. The AI think that the boy is singing the Christmas song, which I think is what we're hearing here. I will let you be the judge on whether this is a Christmas song here. We can also test a more realistic example with these realistic characters in a living room background. In this case, the subjects are pretty obvious in each reference image. So in the prompt, we can just have image 1 and image 2 are sitting together in image 3. Casually talking to each other. And here is the result. Let's try another one with an anime style. In this example, we are combining a character with an object, which is the piano, and to this music classroom background. In the prompt, we describe it as image 1 sitting at the piano from image 2, placed inside the music classroom from image 3. Then here we will select the aspect ratio and add the sound if you want and hit generate.
Hello.
In this one, the AI correctly placed a subject and piano in the classroom. The piano sound effect also synced nicely with the movement in the video. I think this one is pretty good. Reference to video has made it possible to control the entire scene across multiple references, but I haven't shown you the most powerful part yet, how it handles the things that used to be impossible with AI video. Now let's push this further with something more complex. A product that needs to show multiple angles accurately. I want to showcase a product in a 360-degree rotation in one shot. With traditional image to video, I would upload one photo and hope the AI guess what the other sides look like. But with reference to video, I can show the AI exactly what this product looks like from every angle in a single reference. That way, when the product rotates, the AI knows what it should look like from the front, the side, and the back. Also everywhere in between. Here's the image prompt I used to generate a multi-dimensional view of these sneakers. Let's add this background as well. And here's the prompt. The AI understands what a sneaker looks like from every angle. So as it rotates, the details stay very accurate from the logo on the front and also the overall design of the shoe. You can see from the side details, the overall structure remains very consistent. Also, the same logic applies to characters. By providing multiple views of a single reference, the AI keeps them consistent no matter how they turn. For example, I uploaded this multi-view character sheet along with the skating park background. And here's the prompt. Let's change the reference text to the correct ones. After everything is set, we can generate. We can see that it starts from her side view, and the AI even incorporates the small pattern on the right side of her pants. Everything from the seams in the hoodie to the special structures on her pants is well reserved. So that's reference to video. You get complete control over consistency by giving the AI the full picture upfront. Whether it's multiple people, details, or character outfit, you're no longer limited to hoping the AI guessed correctly. Try this with your own projects with a link below. And let me know what you think about this feature. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.